Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we've got a whole bunch of things going on in this video. The first is Merry Christmas. We're days away from Christmas, so it would only be right if I dressed up for Christmas, hence the reindeer. Secondly, there's a reason this looks like a Taliban training video, and it's because I am in the process of building out the studio area so that we can do some really cool things moving forward. I actually have some really cool video topics that would actually utilize some stuff here on the desk so that we can show some mechanics without being in a machine on a job site. That's really exciting. But even more than that, I'm really excited to announce that starting in January, I'm gonna start doing once a month live YouTube videos around 7:30 Eastern time in the evenings so that we can really open a dialogue and you guys can ask questions about things on the job site, how to get into the business, etc. And I'm really excited that this space is going to allow us to do that. So bear with me while I get this wall built out behind me to give us an actual backdrop so that it doesn't look like an Al-Qaeda training video with a reindeer in it. It's actually gonna look like a studio space. So stay tuned because I will announce what day we're gonna start doing those, but that is something that is coming up in January. We're gonna start doing that. So that being said, let's get into the topic for today's discussion, and that is common job site swear words. So why do we use swear words? Well, think about it this way. Without swear words, your world would look like this. Colorless, bland, boring. There's no depth whatsoever. But the second we add in swear words, all of a sudden, there's color, there's depth. It's so rich, and that's the way your language can be on the job site. It would be irresponsible of me to send you out on a job site without at least a fundamental, foundational knowledge of common job site swear terms. So that being said, let's dive right in. Our first word, and by far the most common word you're gonna hear on the job site, is the word and you can use it in so many different ways. This is one of the most colorful, most expressive, most fun words to use because you can use it in so many ways. So you can use it in a positive way, like, oh, f***, that's amazing. This is awesome news. You can also use it in a negative way, like, oh, f***, I can't believe I just did that. Or, oh, f***, we have to work tomorrow. That's a great way to use the word f***. And you'll use that a lot in a negative way. But you can also use it as surprise. If something, like, you randomly get the afternoon off, it's like, oh, f***, we don't have to work this afternoon, that's awesome, we get to go home. So f*** is a very versatile word, and I encourage you to experiment with it and use it in a lot of different ways. Our second term is gonna be the word a**. Now, a**, you may be thinking, is just a not nice word of talking about your backdoor orifice, but in this sense, an a**, is just another word for a jerk. So you may talk about Don over there. You don't wanna deal with that guy because he's just an a**. That's how you properly use the term a**, on a job site. Now, another word that's commonly used in place of is dick, and are really interchangeable. Dick in this sense does not mean a male reproductive organ. It's just another term for. So again, Don over there, who you don't want to deal with because he's an. You don't want to deal with him because he's a. No one wants to deal with a. That's how you're going to use the word. Now, our next term is going to be a little confusing. It's the word. I know so many of you think that that is another term for a female reproductive organ, but in this sense, it's what you would call someone who you think is a wuss or a sissy. Let me put it into context. Let's say you just dug a 13-foot deep hole with no benching whatsoever. There's water running in the bottom of the hole, and it looks like it's going to collapse at any point in time, and you want your laborer to jump down in there. You encourage him into that hole by calling him a dude, get down in the hole and stop being a. Now, is it responsible to send him down in that hole? No, but the way you get around this is by using the word because now it puts the burden on him to prove himself to not be a. And now he has to climb down in that hole. Now, another word that you can use in place of this is the word. That's traditionally a female dog, but in this sense, it can be used as a replacement for the word. So you might be telling your laborer, stop being a, get down in that hole. So and are also interchangeable. So you're already starting to see that with a lot of these words, you can interchange them, you can mix them up, and that's really where swear words get fun. You get to make them your own. So our next and final term is going to be Now, that's not a code word for poop. That is bad. Anything bad is So you might say, I'm not going down in that hole. It looks like Or you might say, oh, it's a rainy day, it's just out. There's a lot of aspects that you can apply the word to. Again, be creative here. you can write your own story with these words. So these are just a couple of our job site swear terms. Obviously, I can't go through every swear term because this would be a 30-minute long video, but these are at least some fundamental basics that will get you started on the road of swearing consistently on the job site. You're not gonna look like a rookie if you go out there and swear. You're gonna look like just one of the guys. And really, feel free to experiment here because you can start making some really complex sentences. So far, I've only used these words on their own, but in reality, you can use them all together. So you might say something like, "Get the f*** out of that hole, you f***ing moron. Why the f*** would you even do that, you f***?" Or you could say something like, "Why don't you stop being a b*** and get the f*** out of that hole?" You can really get creative here. You can string together some really nice sentences, and they're really gonna drive home the point better than just saying it in normal plain English. So that being said, I love you guys. I really appreciate the support. Merry f***ing Christmas and happy f***ing New Year.